Do you want to use inactive relationships in your reports? Relationships are very important in Power BI. It's something similar to joins in SQL. Sometimes you need to join two tables in Power BI using different fields. For example, you have a table in Power BI with three date columns, and you want to join it with the dim date table. But at the same time, only one of these relationships is active and the other remains inactive. So if you want to do some calculations based on the other relationship, you cannot do it. So what's the solution and how you can solve it? Keep watching for the solution. Hello everyone, Shaab is back with another interesting video. Today's session is very interesting and it's coming from your questions. Some days ago, I received a message on my social media account and one of you asked a question which made a problem on her project. So, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and comment your question below this video. And it would be so great if you can like and share this video amongst your friends. You can also follow me on LinkedIn and Instagram and read the Power BI articles on Hogolytics blog. Stay tuned. Some days ago, I received this message that someone asked, "Hey Shahab, I have a table with three different date fields. I should use a filter that contains the three date column names on my report, and my users should use this filter to change the table visualization values based on the selected date column. How can I do this? I've already used the selected value in the calculated columns, but it's not working. It would be great if you have any solution for it." This is a common problem that many developers face. I previously created a short video about the Power BI best practices for date field values. There, I mentioned that you should disable auto date time, create a dim date table, and change your dim date as date table. It's indeed a best practice in Power BI because otherwise Power BI creates a date table in the background that you can't see, and it increases your data model size and decreases your report performance. Let's go back to the question. The problem usually happens is when you have different date columns in your table and when you join it to the dim date table. Only one of them is active and the other relationships remain inactive. So, what is the solution if we need to use the other inactive relationships in our report and do some calculations based on them? Stay with me with an example and you will learn how to solve this issue. Assume that we have a sales table which contains the number of sold products and sales amount. We also have three different date columns for order date, ship date, and arrival date. It's a very simple table just for demonstration. I also created a dim date table and you can watch the related video in the channel on how to create a dim date table in Power BI. So we want to create a visualization and slicers which reports the users about ourselves. Let's save and close the Power Query editor. And then go to the modeling tab. Here we can manage the relationships between tables. So click on manage relationships. In the new window, press on new. In the first drop down menu, choose the sales table. And in the second one, choose the dim date table. Here, because we have only two tables in our model, when you choose the sales table, dim date will be selected automatically for the second one. Now, from the sales table, choose order date column. As you can see, the column color will be changed. And then, select the date column from dim date table and press OK. Our first relationship created. Now, we do the same process for ship date from sales table and date column from dim date table. Press on close. We can also make the relationship by drag and drop. For the third date column, arrival date, I use this method. So drag the arrival date column from the sales table and drop it on date column from dim date table. As you can see, three different relationships created, but only one of them shown as a solid line, and the other two are dotted line. What does it mean? If you click on Manage Relationship button again, you can see the three relationships there, but only in front of one of them you can see the tick mark. Double click on it to edit. As you can see, at the bottom of this window, there is a checkbox which is enabled for this relationship that shows this relationship is active. If I close this window and open another relationship, you can see the check mark is not selected. This means only one of the relationships is active and the other two are inactive. This is what Power BI considers for creating a relationship between two tables. It means you cannot have more than one active relationship between two tables. So, if you have different relationships, one of them will be active and the others remain as inactive. So, what happens if only one relationship is active? Here in the Report tab, if we create a simple table and drag the date column from dim date table and mark it as a date, and the product count and sales amount from the sales table into the table, you can see different numbers for different dates. But what do these numbers show? What date is being used in date column? Order date, ship date, or arrival date? Think for a second. Correct. The one with active relationship. If we go back to the modeling tab, we can see the order date here is active. And these dates shows the number of products and sales amount for each order date. You can check it with the initial sales table. But can you remember the question raised by one of the followers at the beginning of the video? She needs to see the data for different date columns, but unfortunately, only one of the date fields is working. Do you like to know the solution? Keep watching. Here I just formatted the table for better visibility. Now we want to create slicers in which the users can choose one of the three date columns in sales table, and then the table changes based on the order, ship, or arrival date. Cool. First of all, we should create a category table to make the selection in a slicer. So easily create a table. Name it as date selection and name the column as category. Insert three row data: order date, ship date, and arrival date. And then create another column as category ID to use for sorting the other column. And press load. Expand the date selection table. Choose category from the column tools menu. Choose sort by column and select category ID. Now create a slicer, resize it, drag the category field from date selection table into it, and format the visual. Please become sure from the visual formatting pane, choose single select within the selection section. It allows your users to be able to select only one of the dates at the moment. What we are looking is by clicking on each of these items in date selection slicer, the dates, product count, and sale amount in table should be changed based on the selected date. To do this, we should use some measures. First, create a simple table without any data. Call it as key measures. What I am recommending to do, always have separate fields for creating your measures and never create them within your tables. It helps to have a clean and organized model, and anyone opens your Power BI file easily can understand it. go to the key measures table. From the table tools menu, choose new measure and write this measure to calculate the total number of product count. Name it as sales count order date. As you know, because the relationship for order date is active, this calculation will be applied only for the order date. Now you can remove the empty column from key measure table. And you can see the key measure table icon change to a calculator, which shows this field contains measures. Create the second measure as sales amount order date, which is equal to sum of sales amount in the sales table. Now it's the time to create measures for the other two dates and change the relationships. So we create four measures one by one. The first one is sales count ship date. It is equal to calculate, open parenthesis, sum of the product count in the sales table, comma, and then use a relationship, open parenthesis, and now we should define the two fields which should be related to each other. First, date column from dim date table, and then ship date column from the sales table. We should do the same for sales amount ship date, sales count arrival date, and sales amount arrival date. I'm writing these DAX expressions and just speed up the video. You can pause the video to investigate more about each of these codes. Now we have all the required relationships. Next, we need to write two other DAX expressions, which give us the count of products and sales amount based on the selected date from the category in the slicer. We write total product count is equal to. Then we should use an if statement when the value in category from the date selection table is equal to order date. Then, use the sales count order date. If the category from the date selection table is equal to ship date, then use the sales count ship date. And if the category from the date selection table is equal to arrival date, then use the sales count arrival date. Then, we write this DAX expression the same as the last one, to extract the total sales amount. Now remove the product count and sale amount from the table on canvas and instead add total sales count and total sales amount and format the table. To create a title for the table, we can also write this DAX expression. Table title is equal to, if the category from the date selection table is equal to order date, then sales by order date. If the category from the date selection table is equal to ship date, then sales by ship date, otherwise sales by arrival date. Now click on table. Go to General Formatting, expand the Title section, and turn on the toggle. Go to Text, click on FX button, choose Field Value, and then Table Title Measure created in the last step. And finally, Format Size, Font, and Color. Now, if you select any of the categories from the slicer, the dates and numbers will be changed based on these values, and you can see the title of the table show the data is related to which date field. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to the channel and like and share the video. The same as this tutorial, if you comment your question below this video, I will try to answer all them as soon as possible in the next upcoming videos. You can also be in touch with me through my LinkedIn and Instagram and read Power BI articles on Hogolytics channel. Have a good day, all Power BI lovers.